Should I update to Windows 11? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com with an update to an article I published last year, not long after Windows 11 had been announced but not yet released. In the intervening time, Windows 11 has been released, and in fact, I'm using it as we speak. The question, of course, is, well, now that it's released, should I update to Windows 11? The short answer is, unless you know of a compelling reason to do so, no. Windows 10 is going to be around for a long time, and there's no compelling reason in my mind for you or the average consumer to update to Windows 11. It is an interesting operating system. It feels a lot like what I would have classified as a big service pack to Windows 10. There's some user interface changes that have met with some mixed results. There's a little bit of functionality changes. The most controversial part of it was they used the naming change from 10 to 11 as their opportunity to introduce more specific, more restrictive hardware requirements. That's gotten us a lot of press dealing with the TPM and the specific processors that are supposedly supported or not. The bottom line is that the requirements for Windows 11 are actually fairly confusing. And in my opinion, they're probably going to change. Now, one of the important things to realize, and I mentioned this already, is that Windows 10 is going to be around for a very long time. As I record this in January of 2022, Windows 10 is expected to be supported until towards the end of 2025. So that's close to 3 years worth of support for an operating system that, well, it's the most deployed operating system ever. It is on more machines than any previous version of Windows, as I understand it. The bottom line is that because Windows 11 doesn't really bring anything truly wonderful to the table yet, it kind of rates, as I say, a big meh. There really isn't anything compelling. Now, I will say this, and this is one of those things that is hearsay, it's lore, it is not something that's based in fact or science or anything like that, but it is something that a lot of people have noticed over the years, and that's the every other version curse. Here's how it works. If you take a look at releases of Windows since Windows XP, Windows XP, very popular. The next version, Windows Vista, not so much. The next version, Windows 7, very popular. The next version, Windows 8, not so much. The next version, Windows 10, now very, very popular. It's on over a billion machines on the planet. The next version, we don't know. If the pattern continues, it may not be the most popular version of Windows. We just don't know. I'm not saying that this is something to be relied on, but it is something that I find interesting. Now, Windows 11. If you know you have a reason, a specific reason that you need to be running Windows 11, maybe there's a specific feature that I've overlooked or that I don't understand is as impactful as it might be for you, or for whatever reason, or if you get a new machine that comes with Windows 11 pre-installed, then by all means, run Windows 11. The way I describe it is, if you know, you know. If you don't know, if you have to ask the question, you probably don't need to upgrade to Windows 11, at least not yet. I hope that's helpful. I hope that clarifies a little bit of direction and takes a little bit of the FUD away from the Windows 11 upgrade path. For comments, for updates, because this article will get updated from time to time, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/135037. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.